Good morning. How you doing? It's Jim. It's Thursday, the 30th of July, 2020. How you doing? It's been a little while. Those keenly watching and following my every move, which is none of you, will have noticed that I have made very, very few videos. I've been a bit lax, to be honest. It's put it down to, I don't know why I put it down to, just kind of lost, haven't lost my mojo or my enthusiasm. I don't really know what's happened. It's just I've still been listening to music, and a lot of it, and a lot of the bands that we've had on the channel here and we've been listening to together, I've carried on listening to, and I've bought records, I've bought the CDs, I bought the vinyl, and I've kind of done it. But the Mars Volta, I have not. I have bought the CD of this. This is Francis the Mute, which I've loaded into iTunes, but I have yet to listen to the Cassandra Geminni, which is the track that a lot of people are asking about, saying that I really, 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 really should listen to this. Now, I've sussed it out. I've worked out from looking on YouTube, where there have been other videos of this made, that I think it starts with Miranda, the ghost just isn't holy anymore, as the first part of this, and then hopefully all the other tracks will sort of flow into it and it becomes one big, long 32-minute epic. When it comes to putting the video together, I'll sort of obviously sort of extract the audio from iTunes and try to sort of stitch it all together and make it work and so on and so forth. But in the meantime, I do know that this camera here, hello, the recording capacity on here for video is 29 minutes. So it'll probably pack up and I'll have to restart it again sort of as we go through. This one, no problem. That would go for hours. And the audio, which is recording over here on another camera, which you can't see, but it's a really poor quality camera. So that one, again, I think should keep going for as long as I need it to. So hopefully, with a little bit of jiggery-pokery and bish-bash-boshness, should get this to work. Anyway, I am really sorry I've not made enough many videos lately. It's kind of it's not so easy. And although I enjoy doing it, and I quite think the content I make is quite good, I'm not very good at it. I'm quite good at making the video, but I'm not very good at sort of doing the whole sort of promotion and sort of sharing it and all that stuff. So there are other people I know who on YouTube are making videos daily, if not sort of more than that. I was like, where do you get the energy to do this from, and sort of what else are you doing in your life that you can spend all your time doing this? So there we go. Right, let's get this ready to go. I'm sorry. I'm nattering. Absolutely talking about nothing. What a load of old bullshit. Right, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Straight in. I'm gonna move this a bit.
Shopping
like the brass in here. Like the sax. Filthy. Seamless. Very good.
It's working.
Nice drum pattern. A bit psychedelic. Deep. I don't know if that's double bass or lots of horns in here as well.
Yeah.
the track that keeps giving. Nice little bass drums. I think that's the first time I've actually been aware of the bass in here at all. Double track guitar.
There is just so much to take in.
Love this.
Section. In fact, this might be a good place to pause this. Just sync it up again. This feels very, very different from what's preceded it so far. But an absolute relief as well, because I could not maintain that level of energy. I do feel it's probably going to go off again in a minute. Thank you. Oh. Problems, problems, problems. Battery this time. Thank you.
ocean floor is hidden from your viewing lens. A depth perception languished in the night.
All my life I've been so alone, but the seeds sprout like a moon cloud.
I cannot sit here and just spout on about this for a few minutes. I just kind of need to take stock a little bit. Wow. I don't really know what it is. What I feel about this. It is absolutely bonkers, absolutely crazy piece of music. To call it a piece of music is doing it a disservice. It's pieces of music, often at the same time. Absolutely just extraordinary. I'm going to have a little sit down and a cup of coffee and have a think about this and come back to you in a minute. I like it. I've more than I like it. I think I love this. I absolutely love this. And I can absolutely know for certain that music like this is incredibly divisive. That there's a lot of people I know would absolutely hate this with all of their being. They could not think of anything worse to listen to. It's almost like sort of a torture, audio torture. No, it is absolutely phenomenal. The amount of influences I could hear in there is just... It's like sort of listening to every prog band you've ever known and every jazz sort of musician of note you've ever known. So like Miles Davis or sort of John Coltrane and all this. Everything is all thrown in the King. Extraordinary. Absolutely extraordinary. I have no idea where to start with this. I don't think there is anywhere to start with it. It's just... I think this needs to be absorbed and thought about for... I mean, I could go away and think about this and chew the cud, as it were, for days and days and days and not be able to come back with anything constructive to say because there's just too much. And at times it felt like it was too much. I can't take any more. It just keeps coming, an absolute assault on my senses. I can't process what's happening fast enough to keep up with what's happening before something else is happening. And it's just, oh my God. I'm gonna have a little pause and I'll come back in a minute. All right, catch you in a sec. Okay, so I'm back again. I've had a bit of a break. In fact, as much of a break as it's possible to have within the same day. It is now the evening, so I've gone forwards about 6-7 hours from when I was last recording this. Reason being is I just needed to have a little bit of headspace after listening to this madness. It is Cassandra Geminni. It's... Absolutely. As I was saying sort of a while ago when I first was making the video, it is a complete assault on my senses and on my brain. And I just could not really, I really cannot process what it is that I've been listening to in coherent language that you could understand. I still don't think I can do justice to what I've heard. Just only to say that this is one of the most extraordinary the musical experiences I think I've had. It's just absolutely mind blowing. Without sort of sounding too sort of dramatic about it or what have you, it really is. I absolutely loved the modern jazz influence in there. There's sort of the Miles Davis-y and John Coltrane type stuff that was sort of big, big part of that. And then there's sort of psychedelic bit, so it sounded like sort of really early Pink Floyd in places. And then there was just this absolutely sort of chaotic... As a band, actually, been sort of quite in prominence recently because Tim Smith died, who's the front man from the band The Cardiacs, and they are a very, very unknown. I think they are sort of a little known but hugely influential British band that had been going sort of on and off more often in the last recent years because of he had some illness but it was sort of like a really chaotic punk prog. I kind of the only way I can sort of describe it. So it had the energy of punk but the inventiveness of prog, and I think that's actually a label they absolutely loathe and detest and hate. But that's kind of neither here nor there. What I'm just saying is it's that similar sort of barely contained, barely controlled chaos that I feel carries over into the Mars Volta, into their work. Now, I think when I say into the Mars Volta, I think it's probably more the minds of Omar and Cedric, who are sort of like the creative force behind this, and obviously you have other players in there who are sort of bringing their stuff to it. But it's the vision, really, of Omar, and then sort of obviously the lyrical musings and madness of Cedric as well. But it is so off the wall and so far removed from what you anticipate or expect of a piece of music to do that it takes some listening to and, as I say, processing and thinking about, and I don't think I'll ever understand it. And I don't think it's something I want to listen to every day, but it's something I want to listen to again, and I want to listen to it again a lot. But it's music which is just so over the top and so full of ideas and sort of creative endeavor that it is genuinely all music is art, but this genuinely is sort of like the most explosive, chaotic, cataclysmic expression of noise that I can ever recall hearing, and is brilliant, absolutely brilliant. All of the playing on here was phenomenal. There was a long section towards the beginning where I don't think I was aware of bass guitar being played, and all of a sudden I think I said in here, "Oh, interesting little bass." And I said at that point, that's the first time I was aware of the bass playing, but I think up to that point it had been lost and sort of as part of the sort of the bigger sound. So the bass is obviously there, but it was masked and hidden because of everything else that was going on, or just contributing to the overall sonic stuff. Oh, another battery just gone. That's gone over there, so I'll just talk to you now over here. The guitaring, again, really, really interesting guitar playing. Sort of just massively expressive and massively all over the place as well. So it's almost a little bit sort of like a sort of Hendrixian place. So just really sort of free guitar playing, and great. These are such sort of inadequate words to describe what I sort of am feeling about this. The drumming on here is extraordinary. Is this old matey boy Prigion again? I can't remember his name. Who played on some of on the other stuff? I think it probably is. So just incredible. And of course he's Cedric's absolutely mad, over the top, in tune, out of tune, ramblings, musings, vocalization of nonsense and stuff is just the absolutely the icing on the cake of this. So it's just, I want to listen to it again. I can't listen to it again now. It's, as I say, it's done things to me, and I need time to go away and just sort of be at one with something else, maybe some Pink Floyd, something a little bit straightforward, and I don't know. Thank you, everybody, for recommending this. I apologise wholeheartedly for taking so long and getting around to doing it. And I hope that I won't take quite as long between videos next time. It's just, you know, getting around to doing them with life stuff. So, yeah, that's it. This is probably the longest video I've ever made on the channel. I hope you've enjoyed it. I certainly have. I think it's been brilliant. Thank you so much. And I'll see you guys on the next video whenever and whatever that is. And until then, this is Jim over and out.